popped off. Then your girl gave me just a little bit of la chop. Baby so cold, he from the north, he from the Canada. Bankroll so low, I got nothing else that I can withdraw. Ran up the dough, I shot my wrist, it go like sha sha sha, sha sha sha. I got your bitch in me, la 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 la.
Hey y'all, let's talk about the big lick. So, for those of you who don't know what the big lick is, here's a video. Let's dive into the nitty gritty on the big lick. For those of you who do not know what soaring is or want to know more about it, here we go. So basically, soaring is where you take a horse, you go to the softest part of their pasterns, you put things like mustard oil, diesel, chemicals on that, basically bake it into the skin, like every one of these trainers do. They bake it into the skin, therefore making it soft. Here's a picture. Making it soft and just tender. So those chains that they put on there, you'll see those chains, I'll talk about that in a minute, they'll hit that soft spot, making a pain reaction and flinching that horse's leg up. Whenever you soar a horse, you cannot go back. If these trainers did not soar these horses would not be doing the high, stupid, big lick step. And these trainers, whenever they soar these horses, are baking it into their skin, basically. Well, that's what they're doing. They're baking it into their skin. And they do this over and over and over and over. And these horses, some of them cannot even stand because of how bad it hurts. I cannot imagine the pain that these horses have to endure for some high man-made artificial step that wins somebody a blue ribbon. The chains. Most of the people in the walking horse community, I'm not even gonna call it a community, I'm gonna call it a group of idiots. Most of the people in that group, if they have come out and said if they do not have the chains, it ruins the entire walking horse step. Those chains, whenever they hit that soft part of that horse where those chemicals have been baked in right below the pastern, it hurts, and therefore it makes that pain reaction to bring their legs up higher. So whenever those big heavy chains hit that, makes the pain reaction, make the horse hurt worse, but makes a higher step. Some of these chains are hitting so hard because of how heavy they are that they cause the horse to bleed where the chemicals have been baked in, where they've been soared. And the stacks. So these stacks are, each one of them easily weigh 10 pounds. You can see in this picture, the weights on that stack. I'm not sure why you need a stack besides making that horse step and hyperextend its leg to get that weird walk. There's no need for a stack like that to be on a horse, none. Here's a couple more pictures of what those stacks look like. Those stacks are so heavy that each step that horse takes, it looks like they're punching the ground. It's just ripping that horse's legs over and over and over, hyperextending them and just ripping them towards the ground because of how heavy they are. That's why they even add weights. You do not need a bit that stinking long on a horse's mouth with that long of a shank, that big of a bit. Here's pictures. Who needs that to ride? Oh wait, I know, because all these riders on these horses a way too big to be riding these horses. These horses can't even walk straight. So these riders are having to use their, they don't even use their legs. Like, look at this guy. His feet are pointed straight towards the ground. His legs are back. They need those long bits to rip off their horse's face to hold on to because they suck as riders and they do not have balance. The riders. So these riders, most of them are way too big for these horses, way past the 20% rule. Here's a couple pictures. You don't, especially on two-year-olds, most of these horses are 2 years old, running around in an arena, doing some weird walk, a man-made weird walk. These riders in general, they're way too big. Hate me if you want, they're way too big to be on these horses. They're ripping off their horse's face, and so therefore they're putting all that body weight on that bit in that horse's mouth with these shanks. Who would do that? Reverse it here. Put yourself in that horse's position. So you're 2 years old, you have huge stacks on your feet, 10 weight stacks, that are just ripping your legs every single step, way down to the ground, hyperextending your legs. Your legs are bowing out. I'll get to that in a second. You have these chains hitting into where you've been soared. You have your face being ripped off by a way too big of rider who should not be riding you. They're sitting basically on your butt because they don't know how to position a saddle right. How would you feel? Not even to mention having your tail brought up because you have a dog tail. Let me explain what tail docking is. So basically, it's to where the horse's tail is cut. There's a cut tendon that a vet, not many vets do it. It's very hard to find a vet who would dock a horse's tail. But you cut the tendon in the horse's tail, and therefore you put these weird contraptions on it. Here's a picture. Forcing that horse's tail to stay up. And therefore, whenever they go into these shows, they put these things on these horses' tails to force them to keep their tail up because their tail looks pretty. That doesn't look pretty. That just looks like it hurts. That looks unnatural. If I'm going to a horse show, I want my horse to look natural. The horse's tail is a part of their spine. Look at horse anatomy. Here's a picture. The horse's tail is a part of its spine. You cannot be cutting a tendon and then pulling your horse's backbone up. That's not right. That's horrible. And almost all of these horses who have dock tails can't move their tail normally. And horses, they need their tails to swish off flies, mosquitoes, bugs, horseflies, whatever. They need that tail. They can also tell you if they're uncomfortable by swishing their tail. Their tail is a very important part of their horse. Those are horses. So this is how a normal Tennessee walker should move. Tennessee walking horses are naturally gaited. So most Tennessee walking shows are this. Tennessee walking shows have the certain class, the Big Lick class. So these horses are taken 1.5 years old, easily 1.5, sometimes even yearlings. They're forced to wear a saddle on their backs excuse me, I shouldn't even say on their backs, on their hips. These, okay, let's be real, guys. These people do not know how to position a saddle. If they did, they would not have their saddle basically on their horse's hips. So after they break them, I don't even know how they break them. They probably do it the most unethical way. And also, if you're riding a two-year-old in a show, how did you get the proper amount of groundwork, foundation, and everything you need and actually properly break it to even ride it in these shows? And another thing is that these horses, I guarantee you, would buck their riders off. 100%. They would buck their riders off if they did not have the soaring and the stacks. And oh, their face being ripped off. Why? Because these horses, it hurts to stand on it. It would hurt to stand on my feet too. So therefore, they can't really buck. It hurts to way too bad. And these riders are so big. I mean, let's be honest. They're over 75% of these horses' body weights, especially these two-year-olds. After ripping their horse's mouth off with the shanks, the horse, it doesn't even have a chance to fight. Then, after they finish breaking their horses, literally breaking their horses, literally, they then sore them, put stacks on them, have farriers come out, put stacks on them. They then will go get somebody there. It could be a vet there even, to dock their tails. So then they put a horrible contraption on their tail. Does not look natural at all. If anything, it just looks disgusting. Then they're kept in a stall. These horses, they don't even get out into pastures because they can't because of their stacks. These stacks on these horses, basically the only thing that these horses do is they sit in a stall. Who knows what they feed them? Who knows, honestly? They give them, you know, their food. They probably have horrible drinking water, to be honest, if I'm being completely honest. They don't even probably touch their horses' drinking waters. And who knows whenever their stalls get cleaned, honestly, if I'm being honest. You know, those videos they see online of the walking horse barns. Don't believe those. None of those are true. So after these horses sit in these stalls, they don't get to go out in pasture, don't even get to run around and act like horses. The only time that they're ever out moving is whenever a rider's on their back, ripping their mouth off, running them around, or trotting them around, or loping them around, making them hyperextend their legs, thinking that looks pretty. Training them to look pretty trotting around an arena. You know, they look so pretty trotting around an arena like that. If anything, that just disgusts me. It makes me think, who is that cruel to do that to an animal? Who in their right mind would do that to an animal? So here's a video of literally Karen.
My name is Karen.
Okay, Karen.
And I am a walking horse advocate. I will be the first to admit it.
A big lick?
Yes, absolutely. I've had everything, actually. I've had pleasure horses. I've had colts. I've kind of had a little bit of everything, and we love them. These animals are not by any means treated cruelly. They're very, very legislated. Pardon?
Dr. John Hafner, MPSU, says it's animal cruelty. He says it's a business based on the suffering.
Here you go. This might help you. Since you're an
officer,
you don't know about the horse.
No, thank you. I don't want anything from you, sir.
Well, I thought you wanted to learn something.
I know. I saw his hooves.
Yeah, but you want to learn about that?
So, Karen over here thinks that looks good and that's natural and, oh, he was so pretty. They would be beautiful horses if they weren't abused, soared, and have these horrible stacks on their feet. The Big Lick group, it's unbelievable how people can do that to an animal, a living animal. Here's a video of a horse tripping while doing the weird walk, and the rider doesn't even make a face. So there's no telling how many times this horse has tripped or fallen. So he just doesn't care. Like, if my horse falls or trips something, especially like that, I would immediately stop him and let him catch his breath and get off and make sure he's okay. The Big Lick Group says that every single horse before it goes into a show is vetted. What? No, they're not vetted, obviously. And the vets there are paid off. They are paid to look at a horse, say that's okay. And another thing is, in the arena, or in the show ring, these horses, literally, they put spray paint on them. On the parts where you can see it is red and irritated, they spray paint it. So that way nobody can see it. So it must not be there. And anything that's doing worse to the horse, putting spray paint on that? Imagine putting spray paint underneath or below your pasterns if you were a horse. Who would do that? Wait, I know. Idiots. The Big Lick Idiots. That's what their name is. So basically, the Big Lick is taking a horse, a young horse, away from its mother very early, breaking it. Obviously, you know, they do such a good job breaking it, soaring it, then putting a way too big of rider on its back, way too big, putting the saddle basically on the horse's hips. I'm not going to try to sugarcoat it. It's basically on their hips because these people don't know how to position a saddle, obviously. So then they get on these horses. They use these long shank bits, rip their horses' mouths off to trot around an arena and look pretty. You know, then, you know, they have the dog tails. So these horses' tails stand straight up and look so good. No, they don't. So after that, then they put the chains on there. They basically torture these horses to death. Literally to death. Then they just take them to an auction. Whenever they're done, they ship them right to an auction. The auction side of it. I know a lot of people who went to auctions and a lot of rescuers who rescue horses from auctions. Some of their horses are Tennessee walking horses. And, you know, these people are going to claim, oh, well, we like to put our horses in a good place. What do you mean a good place? You know, if I ever talked to Big Lick person, they said, you know, my horse would be going, you know, whenever he's done, he's going to be retired into golden pastures. I'm going to be like, yeah, you mean to slaughter? These horses are going to slaughter. That is where they end up. So as soon as they're done with them, they dump them off into the slaughter pen, into the slaughter pipeline. And most of them are slaughtered if they're not rescued or bought by people who care. And they used to be running these horses through the auctions with stacks. But now that they're getting hate for it, they basically just rip the stack off and throw the horse in the auction. That's exactly what it is. Here's some pictures of... Well, here's a picture of what it looks like whenever they rip the stacks off the horse's feet. It's heartbreaking. Who could do that to an animal? Especially a horse. If you look at a horse and you think, I'm going to basically work this animal to death, then just throw it in a slaughter pipeline, you know, just give it, don't throw it at that auction, then I'm going to go get another one. That is the most heartbreaking thing in the equestrian community. The fact that these people are so cruel to say that he walks like that because he's trained to. He's not trained to, he's forced to. 75% of the horse's weight is carried on their front legs. So in the Big Lick, the horse's weight is carried on almost all the horse's weight is on the back legs. So therefore they bow out like this. Walking horses are beautiful, beautiful animals. They're beautiful. But whenever people, perverted people, get a hold of a beautiful thing, they always corrupt it. It hurts to really even make a video about Big Lick just because of whenever I have to go and pull videos off of online. It hurts to watch that. It really does. Horses, I'm gonna talk a little bit about a horse. If you own a horse, you would know that is your best friend. If you own a horse and you own it correctly, or I guess you do everything correctly, and you actually take care of your animal, that will be your best friend. They will be. Horses, they are amazing creatures. I think it's the most, like, the amazing thing I can tell, like, I've ever seen from an animal, is that they can tell if you're sad, if you're scared, if you're happy. They can tell. And it's amazing how these animals can do that, honestly. Horses are amazing creatures. It hurts so much to make any videos on horses like this, especially in this community. Or group, excuse me, especially in this group. Here's a couple more videos, just so you can really get a good idea of just what it really looks like.
Bye.
and I will stand by this. Big Lick is the worst group. I'm not even gonna call it a community or a sport or a class. It is the worst group of people I have ever seen. It is the worst in all of equestrians, in all of the horse world. It is the worst group. It just breaks me to see horses treated in such bad ways because they are just trying to please the people on top of them. They're just trying to do their best. They just want to please the person who's forcing them to do all these things. They're just trying their best and they're trying to please. But in the end, they're just sheep to slaughter. So that is Big Lick. That is it. If I missed anything or you wanted to see me get deeper into detail, I got pretty deep into everything. I feel like I'm still pretty new to this. I'm still trying. But if you want me to fix or anything, you want me to make another video about Big Lick, or you want me to make a video about something, or even if you want me to make a video about a certain sport or a certain horse breed, I don't care. Comment, let me know. I'll do it. Another thing, I'm wanting to make a video on horse racing. I will be making it. I don't know when it's gonna come out. I don't have a lot of filming time, but I will be making it. I'm not sure when, but it'll come out. If y'all have any experiences about racehorses, please let me know. This video has been fun. Thank you guys. I'll see you in the next one.